Hey, it looks epic. It looks like such an awesome movie. So many layers to it. Now, there's a lot of anticipation for this movie, so we are going to take some time now to dive in a little deeper with François Frenchie Nicolas. He is an entertainment journalist with NStars.com, and he is joining us right now from Los Angeles, the Mecca, the ground zero for the film industry. Good evening, sir. How are you?
Yes, sir. Jimmy, listen, I gotta tell you, this film is so, so good. I'm so happy to be here. How are you?
I'm doing great, man. And we have actually, you know, everybody's been thinking about this for a few weeks. It feels like even a few months. And the movie is epic for a few reasons. And one of the ones that really punches me right in the face is they are bringing together the old and the new by combining three generations of Spider-Man films. Let's kind of hone in right there, because I felt a super nostalgia when I saw the Green Goblin pop up in that trailer just now.
Listen, you said it first, so Marvel Studios, don't get at me, okay? I also saw it on Twitter, which I think is great. I can confirm that Tobey Maguire and Andrew Garfield are a part of this movie, and I think that's what makes this film so special. We've never seen this before. A celebration of three generations of Spider-Man, like, wow. Talk about it being the most highly anticipated for a reason. And then on top of that, you mentioned that we are seeing some of our favorite villains back on screen again, from Sandman to the Lizard, Green Goblin, Dr. Octopus, and then of course Electro, played by the incomparable Jamie Foxx, who adds so much comedy. It's such a great film. Fans are really, really gonna enjoy this, and I think it's such a great way to end off the year.
It is. It really is. And I love the fact, again, we've got all of the generations of Spider-Man, but then we're also bringing, we see one of the other Marvel characters there, Doctor Strange. So we've got the generations of Spider-Man combining with the rest of the Marvel world. So, you know, it's just kind of a mind-blown type of situation there. Talk about what the experience is going to be like for folks that are not comic book fans. They're really getting a lot of bang for their buck here.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, even I think if you walk into the theater not being a Spider-Man fan, like director John Watson and the crew over at Marvel Studios does such a great job bringing it all together and drawing you in. I was very fortunate to go see the film on Monday at the premiere, and man, it felt so great to be back in the theater with the super buttery popcorn and the expensive drinks. But what's so great is that this film is going to take you on a ride. I mean, we were cheering, we were sobbing. Like, man, it's truly an emotional roller coaster.
Oh, man, I'm going to cry as soon as I see the original Spider-Man. Hey, immediately tears for J5. But also, you mentioned something, you know, the industry is kind of evolving, you know, with streaming platforms and whatnot. But this movie is going to be shown exclusively in theaters, since Sony doesn't have a streaming platform. Of course, folks are getting advised to get vaccinated so they can go to the theater. So how different is it seeing this type of movie with so much CGI, so many graphics, and so much action? Why is it necessary to see this in a studio instead of watching it on the small screen?
To be honest, Jimmy, I got real comfortable during this pandemic watching movies on my couch, right?
Right.
I can play it, I can pause it, I can go to the bathroom. And then just recently seeing this film, I forgot. This film is 2 hours and 28 minutes of like Spider-Man greatness. And my biggest advice to fans, please use the bathroom before the movie starts, okay? Because you do not want to miss out on the moment of the action. I literally was sitting there, like, holding it together. Mm-hmm. But it's good, man. It's so great.
It is. And I love the fact that you brought up that it is a 2-hour and 20-minute movie. You know, I tell my mom all the time, if the movie is around an hour and a half or an hour and 15 minutes, I'm probably not going to be there, because that means there may not have been much development of the storyline. So, you know, talk about what the storyline might be like. I know you can't spoil it, you can't give away too much for us, but what could we be seeing for that almost 2.5 hours of action?
There's a lot of action, very heavy in action, a lot of surprises, a lot of faces that, of course, have been a part of the Marvel Universe, but we just haven't seen in a while. Like I said, I don't want to spoil too much, but I think what's also really special is we get to see, over these three Spider-Man films, we've seen the character development from all these different characters. So the way that Marvel has figured out a way to tie it all in with a dynamite ending, I know fans are going to have a good time. Like I said, I don't want to give away too much because the last thing I need is anybody over at Sony knocking on my door talking about why did you give that away, okay?
Yes, sir. Oh, yes, sir. Yes, sir. Hey, ladies and gents, we've been talking with François Frenchie Nicolas, and we will definitely be talking with him in the future. Thank you so much for breaking down the new Spider-Man movie for us all. Best